أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
الحمد لله الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى خصوصا على افضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الامين وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. اما بعد، فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا بني اسرائيل اذكروا نعمتي التي انعمت عليكم واني فضلتكم على العالمين. واتقوا يوما لا تجزي نفس عن نفس شيئا ولا يقبل منها شفاعة ولا يؤخذ منها عدل ولا هم ينصرون. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربنا الهمنا رشدنا واعذنا من شرور انفسنا. اللهم ارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم واجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة. اللهم ذكرنا منهما نسينا وعلمنا منهما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وآناء النهار واجعله لنا حجة يا رب العالمين. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In this hour, inshallah, we shall read four sections of Surah Al-Baqarah, 6th, 7th, 8th and 9th. Here you see that again the address, Ya Bani Israel, Azkuru Ni'mati Allati An'amtu Alaykum. Why this repetition? I told you in the previous session that the first section of this continuous address, it is a dawah, a call, a persuasion. The style of persuasion and dawah is different. And the style of blaming someone, charge shooting him, actually that style is different. So these are two different styles. The seven ayat of the previous section, actually, they are for dawah, for inviting them to accept Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to believe in him, in Quran, and be his companions, his helpers, and to fulfill the covenant that they made through Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which will be described in detail in Surah Al-Araf in ayah number 157. But from here actually starts a long charge sheet against the wrongdoings and evil deeds of Bani Israel throughout their history. So, essentially there are several incidents mentioned in these ayat, and they have been mentioned here very briefly, because some of them have been described in detail in the Madanis, in the Makki surahs. In Surah Al-Araf, for example, many things have been discussed in detail. In Surah Al-Qasas, many things have been given in detail. So here there are references. So we shall not be able to go into detail because we have to complete this recitation of four sections of this surah now. Ya Bani Israel, O children of Israel, O progeny of Yaqub alayhi salatu wassalam, uskuru ni'mati allati anamtu alaykum, remember the blessings that I gave on you, I bestowed upon you, the favors that I did to you. Wanni faddaltukum ala al-alamin, and I preferred you, I raised you over all the nations of the world. There's a very big testimony being given here to the Jews that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at one time in history, He chose them out of all the peoples, all the men on earth, and He gave them the position of their of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's representative on earth. That was the highest position given to them. أَنِّي فَضَّلْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا. Now there is a warning. And be fearful and be mindful of the day. لَا تَجْزِي نَفْسٌ عَنْ نَفْسٍ شَيَّا. When nobody will be able to avail anybody else's help. وَلَا يُقْبَلُ مِنْهَا شَفَاهُ. Nor an intercession would be accepted from anybody. وَلَا يُخَذُ مِنْهَا عَدْلٌ. Nor any compensation will be accepted from anybody. وَلَا هُمْ يُنْصَرُونَ. Nor they will be helped from any quarter. Now this is a very profound ayah. The day of judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given four things about it. No intercessions will be useful, beneficial. Nobody will be able to help anybody else. Nobody will be able to present some compensations. And nobody will be accepted in place of somebody else. You won't be able to relieve your own sons or daughters. You won't be able to relieve your parents, your father or mother. Everybody would have to face his own accountability, his own deeds. لَيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى وَالنَّسَعَيَهُ سَوْفَ يُرَى. And for every human being, there is nothing except for which he himself worked and he himself took the labor of doing something. Only the reward will be of those things. But whatever he did, he will find it, he will see it before him. Now comes starts that charge sheet, long charge sheet. وَإِذْبَتْ جَيْنَاكُمْ مِنْ آلِ فِرْعَونَ. And just remember, when we delivered you from the people of Fir'aun, يَسُومُونَكُمْ سُوَ الْعَذَابِ, they were afflicting you with the worst torment. يُزَبِّحُونَ أَبْنَاكُمْ وَيَسْتَحْيُونَ نِسَاءَكُمْ. They were killing your sons and keeping your women alive. وَفِي ذَلِكُمْ بَلَاءٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ عَظِيمٌ. And in that definitely, verily, there was a big testing and trial from your Lord. Such persecutions you were meeting at the hands of the people of Fir'aun in Egypt. And we delivered you from there. وَإِذْ فَرَقْنَا بِكُمُ الْبَحْرَ. And how did we deliver you from them? When we separated the sea, when we splitted the sea waters, فَانْجَيْنَاكُمْ. And we delivered you. وَأَغْرَقْنَا عَلَى فِرْعَوْنَ. And we drowned the people and the army of Fir'aun. وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ. And you were seeing for yourself. You were there. You were seeing them drowning before your own eyes. وَإِذْ وَعَدْنَا مُوسَىٰ أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلَةً. And when we called Moses alayhi salatu wasalam for 40 nights, definite nights, ثُمَّ تَخَصْتُمُ الْعِجْلَىٰ. But in his absence, you took to the worship of cow. مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَأَنْتُمْ ظَالِمُونَ. And you were the evil doers, you became mushriks, you were worshipping cow and the calf. ثُمَّ عَفَوْنَا عَنْكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ. After that, even after that, we pardoned you, forgave you. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. So that you should be grateful and thankful to us. وَإِذْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ. And just remember and recall, when we gave Moses the book, the Torah, and actually he was called to Tur for the same purpose, for 40 days. As I told you, he kept fast for 40 days. And then he was able to receive the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the similarity. We will be fasting inshallah during the day. And we shall be gathering here to receive some part of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us able to receive this divine knowledge from our hearts as well as our minds. وَإِذْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ وَالْفُرْقَانَ. And remember, when we gave Moses the book and the thing with which difference can be made between falsehood and right and wrong. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَحْتَدُونَ. So that you take to the right path, you avail of the guidance. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ. And remember when Moses said to his people, يَا قَوْمِ إِنَّكُمْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ. O my nation, O my people, you have wronged yourselves. بِاتِّخَاذِكُمُ الْعِجْلَىٰ. By taking to the worship of calf. فَتُوبُوا إِلَىٰ بَارِيكُمْ. So repent and return to your Lord. فَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ And kill yourself. What does it mean? Those of you who didn't take to the worship of calf should kill and assassinate those who worship the calf. This is the punishment of shirk and irtidad in Islam. And this is the old law, law of the book of Torah. And as the tradition goes, the Bible, the Old Testament says, 70,000 of them were killed. The total number was 600,000 who left Egypt with Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu was salam. 600,000. 70,000 out of them, they took to the worship of this calf. And now from each tribe, those people who became kafirs, because worshipping calf is definitely kufr, they became murtad, they had to be killed. Murder, killing is the punishment of intidal in Islam. So actually this is a very important example. فَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ ذَٰلِكُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ People of the same tribe, they are one actually. When they were assassinating or killing their own brothers, it was as if they were killing themselves. فَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ ذَٰلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِنْدَ بَارِيكُمْ This is better for you near your Lord, although it appears to be very cruel, although it appears to be something very bad, killing so many people. But there is good in it. There is the final benefit in it. ذَٰلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِنْدَ بَارِيكُمْ فَتَابَ عَلَيْكُمْ And then he accepted your tawbah. He accepted your repentance. إِنَّهُ هُوَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ Verily, he very much accepts tawbah. And he is very much merciful. وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَىٰ لَنْ نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّىٰ نَرَى اللَّهَ جَهْرَةً And just remember, now you see that in each ayah there is an incident. And in very brief words it has been described. We can't go into details. وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَىٰ لَنْ نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّىٰ نَرَى اللَّهَ جَهْرَةً فَأَخَذَتْكُمُ الصَّاعِقَةُ وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ And just recall when you demanded from Moses, we will never accept you, we will never believe in you, unless we see Allah with our own eyes. Ayanan. When we see Allah with our own eyes clearly and plainly, only then we shall believe in you that actually this Torah has been given to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَخَذَتْكُمُ الصَّاعِقَةُ On this wrong demand of yours, a thunderbolt struck you. وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ And you are seeing it within your eyes and within your sight. When you demanded, when you placed this demand before Moses alayhi salatu wa salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala struck you with a thunderbolt. And you were all dead. ثُمَّ بَعْثَكُمْ بَعْثْنَاكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَوْتِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ But then we raised you again. We raised you alive again. After your death, you had died all of you. But we brought all of you to life, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ So that you may be thankful and grateful. وَظَلَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْغَمَامُ When they were in the Sinai desert, you know, when they came out from Egypt, they were in the Sinai Peninsula. And because this Gaza Strip was inhabited, and there was fear that they will be arrested if they cross this Sinai Peninsula from the northern coast. So they went down, you know, along this, what is that called, Gulf of Suez. And then again the Gulf of Aqaba, then they came up. So then that was a long journey in the desert. There was nothing to eat. And 600,000 people, 6 lakhs of people. And they needed something to eat, something to drink. No water, no food, no shelter. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you see, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing them miracle after miracle. Their escape from Egypt was a miracle. The sea broke into two pieces. It was split. And there was a way for them to cross the river. Then when Pharaoh and his armies came, the two sides of the water met each other and they were drowned. It was a miracle, big miracle. Now three miracles are mentioned here. وَظَلَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْغَمَامُ And we caused the clouds to overshadow you. Wherever this caravan of 600 people was moving, a continuous cloud was going along with them, so that they are saved from the heat of the sun. Zallalla alaykumul ghamam. We gave you the shadow of cloud. Wanzalla alaykumul manna was salwa. And we sent down for you the man and salwa. Man was some sweet grains, and salwa was some birds which came in thousands, and they easily caught them. So they got their proteins from salwa and their carbohydrates from man. So all the requirements, dietary requirements, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled for them by a miracle. Man and salwa. Kulu min tayyibati ma razaqnakum. Eat from the pure things which we have given you. Wama zalamuna. And they then didn't do any wrong to us. They couldn't do any wrong to us. Walakin kanu anfusahum yazlimun. They were doing wrong to themselves. When somebody is not thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is doing no harm to Allah. He is doing all harm to himself. وَمَا ظَلَمُونَ وَلَاكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَسْلِمُونَ. How can anybody do any harm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He is above all these things. So anybody who is disobeying him is doing harm to himself. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا ادْخُلُوا هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةِ. And just recall, when we said to you, enter this city or this town, هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةِ. Now which was that city or town? Here again, Quran doesn't mention the name. Hadihi, this. Enter this town. But you know, the biblical description tells it was the town of Jericho or Ariha. That was the first town that was captured by the Bani Israel after their exodus from Egypt. And that was the beginning of their conquering Palestine. So the first town that fell to them was Ariha or Jericho. It's very important today. In the news you find this name, you know, repeatedly. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا ادْخُلُوا هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةَ فَقُلُوا مِنْهَا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ رَغَدًا. Enter this town and eat bountifully therein with pleasure and delight wherever you wish. وَادْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا. But enter the door bowing your heads. That was very important. When a conqueror enters a town which he has conquered, or an army enters a town which he has conquered, then you know the necks, they are high up, the heads are high, they are proud. But when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered Mecca, his head was bowed down. His forehead was touching the hair of the neck of the horse he was riding. Because this was not the time of arrogance, it was the time of humility before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same commandment was given to them. اُدْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا. Bowing yourself. وَقُولُوا حِتَّةٌ. And repeat the word حِتَّة. حِتَّة meant in Hebrew, حِتَّة. O Allah, اِغْفِرْ لَنَا. Pardon us. Grant us our mistakes. حِتَّةٌ. And bowing with your humility and say, forgive us. نَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ خَطَايَاكُمْ. We shall forgive you your misdeeds or your mistakes. وَسَنَزِيدُ الْمُحْسَنِينَ. And those of you who are good doers, we will increase their rewards. فَبَدَّلَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا قَالًا غَيْرَ الَّذِي قِلَ لَهُمْ. But those evil doers, those who were the evil doers, they changed the word that was given to them by another one which was not given to them. And it is given in Torah, they said Hinta. Hinta, instead of hitta, hinta. Hinta means this wheat. We need wheat. We need wheat. This was the bad habit of these Jews from the very beginning. And we shall find that with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to say raina, raina. So this will, inshallah, we shall read when we go progress further. فَبَدَّلَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا قَالُوا الْغَيْرَ الَّذِي قِيلَ لَهُمْ فَأَنزَلْنَا عَلَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا رِجْزًا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. So we send down upon those evildoers a punishment from the sky. بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ. Because of their rebellion nature, rebellion and disobedience. وَإِذِ اسْتَسْقَى مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ. Again remember the time when the nation of Moses, people of Moses, asked for water. اسْتَسْقَى مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ. اسْتَسْقَى, to demand water, to drink. Because there was no source of water. And for such a big, you know, perhaps there was some camping at some place, and at that place there was no source of water. And now 600,000 people going without water, what condition would have been there, it's, everybody can imagine. Now they gathered around Moses alayhi salatu wasalam. We find this, all these details in Torah, in very lengthy details. They cursed Moses alayhi salatu wasalam. They said, you have done us something very bad. At least we were there in Egypt, although we were slaves, but we were eating and drinking and we were having all the goods of life. Now, although we have become free from that bond of slavery, but nothing to eat, not even water to drink. Where have you brought us? That was the attitude of the people. Now, when they gathered round Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam demanding water, فَقُلْنَا ابْنِ بِعَصَاكَ الْحَجَرِ Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, produce some source of water for us. فَقُلْنَا We told him, we asked him, اِذْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْحَجَرِ Strike this rock with your staff. فَانْفَجَرَتْ مِنْ هُسْنَةَ عَشْرَةَ عَيْنَا There gushed forth from that rock 12 springs. قَدْ عَلِمَ كُلُّ نَاسٍ مَشْرَبَهُ Every tribe knew its place of drinking, because there were 12 tribes. They were the progeny of 12 sons of Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam. And there were 12 tribes. Now look to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He didn't give them one spring. They would have fought each other. So 12 springs gushed out. So every tribe fixed for itself that this is our spring and this is our spring, so that there was no infighting between them on this water. قَدْ عَلِمَ كُلُّ نَاسٍ مَشْرَبَهُمْ كُلُوا وَشْرَبُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ اللَّهِ وَلَا تَعْصَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ مُفْسِدِينَ And as if it was said to them, now eat and drink from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided you. And do not act corruptly, making mischief on the earth. وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَىٰ لَنْ نَصْبِرَ عَلَىٰ طَعَامٍ وَاحِدٍ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given them man and salwa. All the dietary needs were fulfilled by these two. They were getting them without any hard labor, without cultivation, without farming, everything easily at hand. But now they got tired with these two things. Baiskultum, and remember when you said, Ya Musa, O Moses, Lan nasbira ala ta'amin wahidin. We can't be patient with this only one food. Continuously taking one food, this man and salwa, nothing else. فَدْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ So pray to your Lord for us. يُخْرِجْ لَنَا مِمَّا تُمِّتُ الْأَرْضِ He should bring out from the earth what the earth grows. مِنْ بَقْلِهَا وَقِصَّائِهَا وَفُومِهَا وَعَدَسِهَا وَبَصَلِهَا Its herbs, its cucumbers, its garlic, its lentils and its onions. Now these are the things which add taste, you know, to your food. So though, because they were very much accustomed to the taste of these foods, now they demanded these things, because all their dietary requirements were being fulfilled. So now additionally, every man needs something which is tasty. قَالَا تَسْتَبْدِلُونَ الَّذِي هُوَ أَدْنَى بِالَّذِي هُوَ خَيْرٌ Moses said, Do you want to exchange that thing which is better with that which is worse? Adna, or inferior at least. And the meaning is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you a better food, and you are asking for something which is inferior, although there are tastes in it. But actually that food which is nourishing, which is natural, that is much better than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. أَتَسْتَبْدِلُونَ الَّذِي هُوَ أَدْنَى بِالَّذِي هُوَ خَيْرٌ You want to get in exchange something which is inferior. And you want to lose that thing which is superior. اِهْبِتُوا مِسْرَى Now this word, اِهْبِتُوا note. This hubut is not from sky to the earth. The same word, اِهْبِتُوا مِسْرًا Go and settle in some city. And now if you want these things, you will have to cultivate the earth. You'll have to grow these things. All these things, you know, you can't get automatically. You have to settle down. This life of Bedouins and this life of traveling, Now you will have to give it up. If you want these things, ibitu misran fa'inna lakum ma saltum, and then you will get what you are demanding. وَزُّرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الزِّلَّةِ. This ayah is very important. And humiliation was heaped upon them. This is, so to say, conclusion. Due to these misdeeds of yours, due to these misdoings of yours, due to this going astray of yours, you were punished. The punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to you by this decree. وَزُّرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الزِّلَّةِ. Humiliation was heaped upon them. وَالْمَسْكَنَةِ. And they drew the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Misery. Maskara, misery. وَبَعُوا بِغَرَبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ. And they drew on themselves the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يَكْفُرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ. And this is because they used to belie and deny the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَقْتُلُونَ النَّبِيِّينَ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. And they had been killing and slaying the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any reason, without any cause. ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْ وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. And this punishment was given to them because they disobeyed and they were transgressing the bounds of the sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالنَّسَارَى وَالصَّابِئِينَ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Verily all those who believed, that is, who became Muslims, who believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا, and those who became Jews, وَالنَّسَارَى, and the Christians, وَالصَّابِئِينَ, and the Sabis. This was a different nation, and most people think they were in Iraq, and they thought they were following Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Some say they were the people of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam. They were following the sharia of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam. Wallahu alam. Nothing is known for sure. The real thing is, man amana billahi wal yawmil akhir wa amila salihan. Whosoever believes in Allah, has real faith in Allah and the Day of Judgment, the last day. وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. And then he does or he did good deeds. فَلَّهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. For their reward is now with their Rabb, with their Master. It is assured. Their reward is assured with their Master, with their Rabb. وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. And there shall be no fear upon them, and nor shall they be grieved. Now this ayah is a very controversial ayah of the Quran. Some people have inferred from this ayah that having faith in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not essential for salvation. Because here also you note that Iman bil Akhirah and Iman billah, only two basic articles of Iman have been mentioned. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالنَّصَارَى وَالصَّابِئِينَ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. But actually it's a big mistake to argue in that way. Because here you refer to the section number 7, section number 6 of this very surah. This whole discussion starts with an invitation to the Jews to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it is as if, you know, in arithmetic, you know, there is some sum which is outside the brackets. And it is multiplied by all the quantities that are within the brackets. Here actually, this whole discussion is governed. It will be at every moment, at every place, it will be multiplied by the contents of those 7 ayat which came in the beginning. That is why, you know, there is a very close similarity between this bracket, the word I am using, because the 2 ayat with which this discussion has now started, يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَتِيَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَأَنِّي فَضَّلْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا لَا تَجْزِي نَفْسٌ عَنْ نَفْسٍ شَيْئًا وَلَا يُقْبَلُ مِنْهَا شَفَاعَةٌ وَلَا يُؤْخَذُ مِنْهَا عَدْلٌ وَلَا هُمْ يُنْصَرُونَ. The same 2 ayat will come in the beginning of section 15. يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَتِيَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَأَنِّي فَضَّلْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. The same 2 ayat. What does it mean? The bracket starts with these 2 ayat, and brackets end with those two ayat. And before this bracket are the seven ayat of section 6. And you know the main theme of that section is وَآمِنُوا بِمَا أَنزَلْتُ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا مَعَكُمْ وَلَا تَكُونُوا أَوَّلَ كَافِرٍ بِهِ وَلَا تَشْتَرُوا بِآيَاتِي ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا وَإِيَّايَ فَاتَّقُونِ يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَتِيَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَأَوْفُوا بِعَهْدِي أُوفِ بِعَهْدِكُمْ وَإِيَّايَ فَارْهَبُونِ. So basic subject is the call to the Jews to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Quran. Now that common factor has been taken out, outside the bracket. It is not being repeated everywhere now, but it is governing the whole passage, the whole address, you know, that is commanding, and that is governing the whole passage, and that is actually the meaning. Now if we gaze our eyes and fix our gaze on this ayat, what does it mean? It means that at the time of every ummah, there was a time when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not born. Up till that time, the ummah was Nasara. Whosoever Christian at that time believed in Allah and the Akhirah and did good deeds, well, his reward is assured with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is safe, he will get the reward. Before Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam, it was the days of the prophethood and messengerhood of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Any Jew who actually believed in Allah and Yawm-e Akhirah and he was going the deeds, well, his reward is also assured. So actually this pertains to the periods of every ummah, that from every ummah, only belonging to an ummah is not decisive in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you are a Jew, even in the days before Hazrat Masih alayhi salam, if there was a Jew, if he was not doing good deeds, if he didn't have real belief in Allah, well, his deeds were meaningless in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he had no position. Even for the Muslims today, if we only profess to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the era of Muhammad now, after the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everybody has to believe in him. But only believing in him doesn't mean anything, unless we really believe in Allah, unless we really believe in the day of judgment, unless we really believe in the hereafter, unless our good deeds are there, and they are just, you know, rationally proportional to our beliefs and our professions, then actually, unless these things are there, being a Muslim, being counted a Muslim in this world, doesn't mean anything on the day of judgment. So this is the essence of this ayah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالنَّصَارَى وَالصَّابِئِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورَ. And remember, when we took the covenant from you and we raised the mount over you, over your heads, فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورَ فَخُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ. Again, it's a miracle. When the Torah was given to Moses alayhi salatu wasalam, when he came to his people again, then he saw that people had started worshipping calf. Then, as we have read, the punishment was then, and that punishment was carried out. Then again, Hazrat Moses took alayhi salatu wasalam with him 70 people. They went again to the Tur, and there they repented before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and now they made a firm covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now to have that covenant very serious, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised the mountain over their heads. These miracles were happening then, at that time. But you know, from the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, now the miracle is only this Quran. It's the intellectual miracle, and not a miracle seen by these eyes or by these, heard by these ears. Not sensual miracles, but actually now the miracles are intellectual miracle, and that is Quran. But before that, we may say that was the infancy of mankind. And so these miracles were shown to them. But with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and this ummah, not such miracles. But you have to understand, and you have to follow, and you have to act, and you have to act through accepting all the hardships of this world. And then you have to fulfill your duties. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورَ خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ. Hold fast to what we have given to you. وَاذْكُرُوا مَا فِيهِ. And remember whatever is there in it. That is means Torah. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So that you are saved from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are saved from His displeasure. You are saved from the day of, from His punishment on the day of judgment. ثُمَّ تَوَلَّيْتُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلَكَ. But then you turned away after this, after making that covenant. Well, your deeds and actions were to the contrary. فَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ. Had there been no grace and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over you, لَكُنْتُمْ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. You would have been among the losers long ago, long before. وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْتُمُ الَّذِينَ اَعْتَدَوْا مِنْكُمْ فِي السَّبْتِ. And you know very well, those of you from you who transgressed the matter, the law of Sabbath. Now this was a very hard law in the Sharia, and that was that this Saturday, this Yawm al-Sabt, actually to them also this Friday was given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But they themselves preferred from Friday and they chose Saturday. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided it for them. Well, this is the sacred day for you. You can't do any work, any worldly work, any work of earning anything. This whole day is reserved for remembering Allah, for reading Torah, for zikr, for salah, for prayers, and so on. No work can be done. But you know, there was a tribe of theirs which was on the shore, seashore, at Aqaba. This is a famous place now. That tribe, you know, that lived at Aqaba. And catching fish was their profession. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested them. The details will come, inshallah, in Surah Al-A'raf. So here we don't have time to go into detail. But they transgressed the law of Sabbath. And you know very much, very well, those of you amongst you who transgressed the law of Sabbath, we said to them, Kulu qiradatan khasein. As a punishment, we said to them, be monkeys. Be you monkeys, despised and rejected. فَجَعَلْنَاهَا نَكَالًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهَا. And we made this punishment an example for the people who were present before them and people who came after them. People who were their contemporaries, they knew that this nation, this tribe of ours has been given this worst punishment in the last. So then they became an example. An exemplary punishment was given. So we made them an example for people who were with them, present at that time, and people who were coming after them. وَمَعِذَةً لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And it became a lesson and a sermon for people who have any fear of God. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَىٰ لِقَوْمِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَذْبَحُوا بَقَرَةً. Another incident, a very interesting incident indeed. And remember when Moses said to his nation, to his people, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala demands from you, أَن تَذْبَحُوا بَقَرَةً, that you sacrifice a cow. قَالُوا أَتَتَّخِذُنَا هُدُوَةً. They said, do you make fun of us? Because there was the germs, you know, that they thought that cow is sacred. Now they were being tested on that account. So they wanted to just somehow get away from this. So they said, do you want to make fun of us? أَتَتَّخِذُنَا هُدُوَةً. قَالَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ. Musa said, alayhi salatu wasalam, I take refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from becoming among the jahileen, from those people who are ignorant and foolish. That you don't expect this, that I can make fun of you. I am the messenger of Allah, I am his prophet. You know it very well, you believe in me. And then you are saying that I am making fun of you. قَالُوا لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا هِيَ. They said, call your Lord. He should explain for us what type of a cow he wants, what type of a cow he wants that should be sacrificed. قَالَ إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ لَا فَارِضٌ وَلَا بِكْرٌ. Moses said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it should be a cow which is neither too old nor too young. أَوَانٌ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ. Between the two, in between, somewhere in between. Neither too old nor too young. فَفْعَلُوا مَا تُؤْمَرُوا. Now do what has been commanded to you to do. قَالُوا دُوْ لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّ لَنَا مَا لَوْنُهَا. They again said, again call your Rabb, your Lord. He should explain to us what should be the color of the cow that we should sacrifice. قَالَ إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ. Moses said, Allah says, إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ صَفْرَاءُ. That should be a cow which is yellow colored, فَاقِعُ لَوْنُهَا, bright in its color, لَوْلُهَا تَسُرُّ النَّاظِرِينَ, pleasing to the beholders. Whosoever sees, he is pleased to see it. Very shining yellow color. قَالُوا دُعْ لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّنْ لَنَا مَا هِيَ. Again they said, call your Rabb, call your Allah. He should explain to us, make it clear for us. What is that cow that he wants in sacrifice? إِنَّ الْبَقَرَ تَشَابَهَ عَلَيْنَا. These cows, you know, they are all alike to us. Or we have become confused about the cow. Which type of cow or which cow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to sacrifice. وَإِنَّا إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهُ. And we shall be, inshallah, we shall be on guided and we shall be on guidance. When the things become clear, we don't want to shirk it, we shall do it. But please make everything more clear. قَالَ إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ لَا ظَلُولٌ تُسِيرُ الْأَرْضِ. He said, Moses said, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is a cow that is not trained to till the soil. لَا ظَلُولٌ تُسِيرُ الْأَرْضِ. Tilling and cultivating the soil, وَلَا تَسْقِي الْحَرَسِ, nor it waters the lands, the fields, from the wells, you know, fetching water. مُسَلَّمَةٌ, it should be of one color throughout. لَا شِيَةَ فِيهَا, there should be no dot of any other color. قَالُوا الْآنَ جَيْتَ بِالْحَقِّ. Now there was no other option, no other question more to ask, and then they had to say, الْآنَ جَيْتَ بِالْحَقِّ, now you have made everything clear, and you have told us the true thing. وَمَا كَادُوا يَفْعَلُونَ, they were not ready to do it. But they did it. After all, they had to do it. وَإِذْ قَتَلْتُمْ نَفْسًا فَدَّارَاتٌ فِيهَا. And when you killed a person from amongst you, فَدَّارَاتٌ فِيهَا, and then they started dispute over blaming each other as to who killed him. وَاللَّهُ مُخْرِجٌ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْتُمُونَ. And Allah was to clear out and bring about what you were concealing, what you were hiding. قُلَّنْ رِبُوهُ بِبَعْضِهَا. We said, strike this dead body of this person with some part of the body of that cow which was sacrificed. كَذَلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى. Now what happened? When they touched that body of the person who was slain, who was killed, who was murdered, with some part of the body of the cow that was sacrificed, he became alive and he told the name of the killer, the murderer who had murdered him, and then he again died. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed them this sign. كَذَلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى. In the same way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring to life all the people who are dead. People who are dead, they will be brought to life. Just as this person who was murdered, who was killed, who was dead before your eyes, and he became alive, and he told the name of the murderer, and the killer, and then he again was dead. وَيُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِهِ. And he shows you his signs. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. So that you understand, and you ponder upon them. ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ. Then after all this, your hearts hardened, hardening of the hearts. فَهِيَ كَالْحِجَارَةِ. And now they are like stones. أَوْ أَشَدُّ قَسْوَةً. Or harder, more hard than stones even. ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ is very important ayah. We must focus our attention. If this thing happened to Bani Israel, this can happen to us, and it has happened to us. The same hardening of the hearts, the same hypocrisy, the same wishful thinking, all those things which cropped up in the former Bani Ummah, they cropped up in the present Muslim Ummah also. ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَٰلِكَ. And then after all this, your hearts hardened. فَهِيَ كَالْحِجَارَةِ وَأَشَدُّ قَسْوَةً. Now they are like stones in hardness or more than them. وَإِنَّ مِنَ الْحِجَارَةِ لَمَا يَتَفَجَّرُ مِنْهُ الْأَنْهَارُ. Because there are rocks, there are stones, from between which the springs gush out. There are springs gushing out of the stones. وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَشَّقَّقُ. And among these stones and rocks are those which split. فَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهُ الْمَاءُ. And water comes out of it. وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَحْبِتُ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ And among the stones and rocks are those who fall due to the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ And Allah is not ignorant of what you are doing. Your deeds, your actions, they are all in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَفَتَطْمَعُونَ يُؤْمِنُوا لَكُمْ Now as a brief pause, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing apparently the Muslims. But here again, actually, the people who are being discussed are the Jews. But this ayah is addressing Muslims. أَفَتَطْمَعُونَ يُؤْمِنُوا لَكُمْ O Muslims, do you hope or wish that these people should believe in you, should believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do you hope? You have any expectations? You wish it? You covet it? أَفَتَطْمَعُونَ يُؤْمِنُوا لَكُمْ وَقَدْ كَانَ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ When if some people among them have been so much courageous against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَقَدْ كَانَ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ يَسْمَعُونَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ That they were hearing the kalam of Allah. ثُمَّ يُحَرِّفُونَهُ And then they have been changing it, corrupting it. مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا عَقَلُوهُ After having understood it, not by mistake, but by willful wrongdoing, they have been changing the words of Allah, the kalam of Allah. So people who dare changing the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how do you hope that they will come to the right path and they will believe in you and in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? أَفَتَطْمَعُونَ أَن يُؤْمِنُوا لَكُمْ وَقَدْ كَانَ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ يَسْمَعُونَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ يُحَرِّفُونَهُ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا عَقَلُوهُ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ And they were doing all these things knowingly, with intention. وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا And when they meet the people of faith, the mu'mins, they say, we are also mu'mins. I have discussed it in the section number 2 of this very surah. وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا And here you see, they are definitely the Jews about which these words are appearing here. There I told you, that both the Jews as well as the Munafiqun, they were there in the background of the second section of the surah. Here they are definitely the Jews. وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَإِذَا خَلَا بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَىٰ بَعْضٍ And when they are privately meeting with each other, two Jews, قَالُوا وَتُحَدِّسُونَهُمْ They say to each other, are you telling them, that is the Muslims, بِمَا فَتَحَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has disclosed on you, those things which have appeared in Torah in support of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you want to tell the Muslims those things? لَيُحَاجُّوكُمْ بِهِ إِنْدَ رَبِّكُمْ فَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ So that they can argue against you on the day of judgment before your Lord, before your Rabb. So do you not understand? Don't you have any understanding? What are you doing? Now please understand, there were some moments that a Jew, in some good moment, he used to say to the Muslims, yes, about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, such and such, you know, there are these prophecies and these things we find them in Torah. But now they blamed each other when they met each other. What are you doing? You are telling them these things? Which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told you, has opened upon you, so that they will now argue against you on the day of judgment. Oh Allah, they accepted and they had recognized Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they said to me that in Torah we find all the qualities and all the prophecies regarding Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they were blaming each other. Why do you tell them that in Torah there are the prophecies which support the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? أَوَلَا يَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ Do they don't know that Allah knows whatever they are hiding and whatever they are revealing? Even if they don't tell the Muslims, Allah knows it, that all the prophecies in Torah were present about the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the signs were present. So Allah will argue against you himself. أَوَلَا يَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ Even if the Muslims don't know, even if they don't disclose all these things to the Muslims, after all, Allah knows them. وَمِنْهُمْ أُمِّيُّونَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ الْكِتَابَ إِلَّا أَمَانِيَّ وَإِنْهُمْ إِلَّا يَظُنُّونَ. From among them there are ummis also. Now what are these ummis? The illiterate people among the Jews. Because all Jews were not ulama. All Jews didn't read Torah, just as we don't read Quran. We go and ask the masala from Maulvi Sahib, that's all. And we read Quran only to get sawab. And that is also a very small percentage of the Muslims who read Quran now. Gone are the days when the majority of the Muslims used to recite Quran every morning. Gone. Long ago. Finished. Very few percentage of the Muslims recite Quran regularly. And among them also, how many people understand it? So actually the same was the case of the Jews. We have at least the whole Quran with us in best bound form and on best paper and printed everything. Do you know about 2000 years before, there was no such facilities available. So actually, very few people among the Jews knew Torah and what was there in Torah. So that is what is Quran saying here. Minhum ummiyun, la ya'lamun al-kitab. Among them are those unlettered people, uneducated people, illiterate people who don't know the book. They say they believe in Torah, but they don't know what is Torah. Illa amaniya. What they know are their wishful thinking. We are the chosen people of the Lord. We are the progeny of Yaqub and Ibrahim and Ishaq. We will be definitely saved from the fire of hell because we are very dear to Allah, like sons. We are very dear. Nahnu abnau Allahi wa ahibbahu. And even if fire touches us, it will touch us only for a few days, numbered days. We shall not remain in the hell forever. All these are amani. These are their wishful thinking. They have themselves, you know, created these things out of nothing. This is a fiction. This is not something from Torah. وَمِنْهُمْ أُمِّيُّونَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ الْكِتَابَ إِلَّا أَمَانِيَّ. And if you try to just assess the position of the Muslims also, the same is the condition of the Muslims. We also have the same amani. We are the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. جو کچھ بھی ہے لیکن تیرے محبوب کی امت میں ہے. Because we belong to the ummah of your mahbub sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, our destiny is fixed. Our positions in Jannah are reserved. Our seats are reserved over there. Our salvation is ensured. So that is actually the wishful thinking. وَمِنْهُمْ أُمِّيُّونَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ الْكِتَابَ إِلَّا أَمَانِيَّ وَمَيْنْهُمْ إِلَّا يَظُنُّونَ فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ الْكِتَابَ بِأَيْدِيهِمْ. Now the other people, they were the Jews, ulama, the rabbis of the Jews. What did they do? They wrote the book with their own hands, changed the wordings of the book, then they sold their fatwas, just as you know some of the Maulvis today sell the fatwas. They get prices by selling fatwas. Just as a person, you know, wishes to get a fatwa, he can get a fatwa, he can purchase a fatwa. There are those ulama'is too, not all of them, but there are some people. So that was the character of the ulama. فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ الْكِتَابَ بِأَيْدِيهِمْ. Woe to the people who write the book with their own hands. ثُمَّ يَقُولُونَ هَذَا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. And then they say, this is from Allah. لَيَشْتَرُوا بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا. So that they can get very little price, you know, for that. Because the biggest price that they can get is actually a little price. If you compare it to the salvation in the hereafter, what will you get? Thousands or lakhs of rupees or dollars, nothing else. But you know, what are you losing? The salvation of the hereafter. The eternal life of Jannah, that is you are losing. And you are getting this price. لِيَشْتَرُوا بِهِ سَمَنًا قَلِيلًا فَوَيْلٌ لَهُمْ مِمَّا كَتَبَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ. Woe to them due to what their hands wrote. وَوَيْلٌ لَهُمْ مِمَّا يَكْسِبُونَ. And woe to them for the earnings that they have made through this business and trading of religion. وَقَالُوا لَن تَمَسَّنَ النَّارُ إِلَّا أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. إِلَّا أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. Again the same example of their wishful thinking. And they said, Nar, fire of hell cannot touch us, except for a few days, few numbered days. Some said 7 days, some said 9 days, some of them said 40 days, not more than that. وَقَالُوا لَن تَمَسَّنَ النَّارُ إِلَّا أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَةً. The fire of hell cannot touch us, except for a few numbered days. قُلْ أَتَّخَذْتُمُ اللَّهَ أَتَّخَذْتُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهِ أَحْدًا. Ask them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, have you got some covenant from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? فَلَنْ يُخْلِفَ اللَّهُ أَحْدَهُ. And you hope and you are sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not do against His covenant? Where is that covenant? أَمْ تَقُولُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Or in the alternative, are you saying about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what you don't know, without any knowledge, without any basis? You are saying these things and ascribe these things to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bala, now this is the final words of this section. And these are the eternal laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bala, why not? Man kasaba sayyatan. Whosoever willfully earns even one ill-doing, one bad deed. Sayyatan. Sayyatan, one deed, one bad deed, one bad act. One sin. But it should be a big sin. Kabira. وَأَحَاطَتْ بِهِ خَطِيَّتُهُ. And then the sin, you know, it surrounds his whole personality. Even one sin can surround the whole personality of that evil doer. فَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. They are the people of fire and they will remain in that forever, forever. خُلُود فِي النَّارِ. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. On the contrary, this is the usual case in Quran. Whenever there is a mention of hell and the people of hell, simultaneously, as a simultaneous contrast, people of heaven, people of Jannah, they are also mentioned as a contrast. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. As for those who believed in Allah, who believed, who had the faith, real iman, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. And the proof of real faith is amal salih, that the deeds should be good, character should be good, his behavior should be good. Good should come out from his person. It should spread from his person into his society. Ulaika ashabul jannah. They are the people of Jannah. They are the people of heaven. They are the people of paradise. Hum fiha khalidun. And they will dwell in that forever and forever. So that is the divine law. Everything is based on real iman and real amal salih, not on the basis of belonging to any community. You might belong to the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but if you don't have real iman and if your deeds are not good, you are not performing your duties, well, your just disconnection, your belonging to the Muslim Ummah, it carries no weight on the day of judgment in the balance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.